Some people worry about chords and stuff. For what we do, that was the beauty of it. You can learn it that first day.
You do need chords in order to plug the guitar in, but that's pretty much it.
It's been 13 years since the last Half Japanese album, and I just couldn't be happier with this one.
Well, being the record nerd that I am, I first heard Half Japanese when the first 7-inch EPs came out. And the Half Japanese singles were just, you didn't know what to make of them. I mean, they were really wonderful and kind of otherworldly. If I were going to describe it to someone who hadn't heard them, I'd just go, well, it's kind of not describable. They invented their own genre, and I'm not even sure what that is.
When that first record came out, it was like this alien object from some other planet. What were these guys thinking? What were they trying to do? Who were these mysterious people?
My friend Stephen Pastel said, Douglas, there's this record I think you would really get. I think you'll just really love it. And I saw the cover, and it was half Japanese, the band, the would-be king, and the front cover was a painting of Jad Fair having a boxing match with Elvis Presley and knocking Elvis the king out. And you know, I couldn't believe that a record that had this cover was something that I wouldn't love.
Half Japanese is in fact the band that would-be king, were they given the opportunity. And that is not the hope or the wish to be king, just to make a living and have your music heard by all the people who would like to hear it. And I think the band that would-be king cover is the best album cover I've ever seen. Jad is fighting Elvis. And on the back cover, Jad wins.
I first heard the band when I was a teenager, and I was just learning how to play guitar. And I remember at the time I was really obsessed with what I couldn't do. And listening to a band like Half Japanese started me down this path where I became less fixated with what I was supposed to do and more focused on figuring out what I had to say. And it was one of the first times in my life that I actually thought, hey, maybe I could do this.
I remember seeing Half Japanese in the early 90s at this small place in Philadelphia called Silk City. And the band must have come in late because they were doing a line check right before the set was about to begin. And the sound man noticed that Jad had not plugged his guitar in. So he looked up at him, kind of gesturing, you know, can I plug this in for you? Your guitar's not plugged in. And Jad looking down and saying, no, I like it that way. So he preferred to not have his guitar plugged in for the set.
You know, they're originals in the way, kind of same way that maybe Captain Beefheart was, but it just was kind of themselves. And really, all you can do in art or whatever it is you call this stuff that we do is be yourself to the best of your ability.
Since the very beginning, Half Japanese has intrigued and struck their own path, created their own road, really unlike anyone else. I'm looking forward to hearing the new one.
For me, what makes these guys so appealing is the fact that they're genuine artists, real artists, and probably had no choice. But I think most importantly, they know that up is there and down is over there.
What do we want out of art in general? We want passion, we want integrity, we want wildness, we want insanity. We want uncontrolled heart, we want soul, we want brains, we want ideas, we want surprise. What do we want out of music? Well, we want Half Japanese. It's about time we got more.
I've just heard that Half Japanese have a new album coming out really soon. I'm really excited by that news. Half Japanese, undoubtedly the greatest rock and roll band of all time.
Boom, boom, Well, this is Jad Fair, and I'm very happy to say that Half Japanese will have a new album out on Joyful Noise Recordings. And the album is called Overjoyed. And I really am overjoyed. Yeah.